I'm at Rottnest Island. Each year, over 500,000 people visit to enjoy a range of activities, but something that everyone here wants is access to electricity. Today, we're going to discover the orchestra of science and engineering going into electricity on Rottnest Island. Rottnest Island has a ridiculous amount of sunny days, and they've taken advantage of that by installing the solar farm. At the moment, it's producing about 500 kilowatts of power, but that's not all being used. People are out enjoying their days at the beach, and energy demand is low. On the other hand, when the sun goes down, people start turning on their lights and air conditioning, so demand goes up. But there is no energy being produced. We need to find a way of storing the excess energy produced during the daytime and releasing it during the night, when demand is higher. One common method of energy storage is using hydroelectric dams. As I'm demonstrating for you now, they work by using excess energy to lift water up to a certain height, where we can then use it to fill up a dam. When demand for energy is high, but production is low, we can then release some of the water, using it to produce electricity. Unfortunately, this system isn't going to work for Rottnest. That's because we don't have high enough mountains to pump the water into, and we don't even have enough water in the first place. Because of these reasons, we're going to have to find an alternate method of storing energy. Rather than making energy supply meet demand, instead we can make demand meet supply. Behind me is the Rottnest desalination plant. It takes in salty water from the ocean, passes it through a fine mesh to take out the salt, and gives us fresh water. It's really effective. In fact, lots of the water you drink at Rottnest is from this plant. But it's also very energy intensive, taking up a significant portion of Rottnest's energy budget. Once salt is removed, this water can then be pumped up into one of these massive storage containers. Combined, they can supply the island with about 30 days of clean drinking water. This means that Rottnest can turn its desalination plant on or off, depending on renewable energy production, as compared with customer demand. When lots of energy is being produced, but people aren't using it, the desalination plant uses this excess energy to purify water. When people are using the energy, the desalination plant turns back off. But because of the storage containers, fresh water is still available. Diesel power is there to make up for any deficits, but because the biggest energy drain is turned off, much less fuel needs to be used. Just across from the desalination plant, we have the Rottnest Island wind turbine. At the moment, it's producing about 350 kilowatts of power due to the wind blowing in from the Indian Ocean. But that wind power and the energy being produced can vary wildly over the space of only a few minutes. Electricity in a wire is a bit like water through a hose pipe. Everything that goes in one end has to come back out at the other. If too much energy is being supplied but not enough used, then this excess energy will try to get out in any way that it can, resulting in blown fuses and molten wires. On the other hand, if not enough is being produced, then your electronic devices just won't work. Larger power grids which supply entire cities are a little bit more robust, but Rottnest's smaller grid has to exactly balance energy in with energy out. There are two ways of keeping our system stable: have fine control over supply or fine control over demand. For supply, a common method is by using a diesel generator. If not enough energy is being produced, then you can speed up the generator too much and then slow it down. This does work, but takes a while to respond to changes in energy because of the large inertia of the motor. Another problem is that you have to keep it running at all times, meaning that regardless of how much renewable energy you're producing, you still have to be burning at least some diesel. The alternative to this is by using a resistor. Behind me is the solution to Rottnest's power variability problems. This is a dynamic resistor, meaning it can change its impedance to the flow of electricity on a moment-by-moment basis. As you can see in the infrared, it does this by converting electrical energy into heat energy. You can increase the resistance if too much energy is being produced, and decrease it if too little. Because of the dynamic resistor, Rottnest is able to use about 5% less diesel fuel every year. A question that you might be asking is, why don't we just install a really big battery to solve these problems for us? And that's a good point. In fact, Elon Musk just installed such a system in South Australia. But there are a few issues with this. First of all, it's really expensive, and the lithium used is environmentally damaging. But what I think is the most important is that what we've shown here at Rottnest is that we Australians have the skills and passion to solve our own problems, finding solutions that are unique to our own specific circumstance. Of all the things we've learned here at Rottnest today, I think that is the most important. Massive thank you to the Rottnest Island Authority for letting me come and film here. This is such an amazing island to explore, and I'm so happy that they shared it with us. New episodes of Perth Science are landing every month, so make sure to subscribe to the channel so as not to miss them. Until next time, this has been James Dingley from the Atomic Frontier. Keep looking up.